This is Nahum 3:1. It says, woe to the bloody city, it is full of lies and robbery. The prey departeth not. Because of the multitude of the whoredoms of the well-favored harlot, the mistress of witchcrafts, that selleth nations through her whoredoms and families through her witchcrafts. Behold, I am against thee, saith the Lord of hosts, and I will discover thy skirts upon thy face, and I will show the nations thy nakedness, and the kingdoms thy shame. And I will cast abominable filth upon thee, and make thee vile, and will set thee as a gazing stock. I'm going to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakak Wadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone who rule well. Peace and salutations to the elect, and much respect to the brothers pushing this word in the four winds of the earth. And shalom to you few sincere sisters out there as well. It's Brother Ariyah coming at you with another lesson. Now, that's the first time I had seen that video before. I'm pretty sure other brothers caught wind of it early, and I'm pretty sure did lessons on it. I've never seen that before, so I felt compelled to do a lesson on it because that's the very technology Esau been using for the longest, man. You know, he used it during September 2001, okay? You know what I'm talking about. He used it then, you know, right before all our eyes. And shit, I thought it was real, you know? Come to find out it wasn't, you know? But it was really a, you know, an inside job, man. Okay, and now we just got this dude who just shot, you know, killed 18 to 20 people and injured maybe 50 more, 60 more people. You know, these psyops, man, even that war that's going on over there, you know, between Hamas and Israel, man, all these things are psyops, man. You know, we really don't know what's really going on, man. All we know is what this devil is showing us. You know, and he's using witchcraft, man, which the media, you know, the news is one of his tools of witchcraft, man, you know. And we know that, you know, there's going to be more false flag events, you know, maybe a fake incoming, you know, invasion or whatever, you know. Something, he's going to cook some bullshit up that's going to deceive a lot of people, man. You know, that shit is coming. It's coming real soon, man. A lot of people are going to be deceived by this man, not only by the MOTB, but they're going to be deceived by, you know, the shit that this man cooks up next, man. But it's all through the spirit and power of the Heavenly Father first and foremost. All right, let's get Revelation 18. Yeah, something about to happen, man. I was watching Elder Hawad's lesson yesterday. He was saying that a lot during his lesson. I guess I think he was walking down the street, you know, around his neighborhood and all that. And he kept saying he could feel something in the air. He could feel like something's about to happen. And all of us, we all had that same feeling, man. Like something is about to happen, man. Something, you know, something big is about to happen, man. Something big is definitely about to happen, man. You could feel it. You could feel it in the air. You could feel it in your spirit, man. You could feel it. Let's get Revelation 18:23. And it says, and the light of a candle shall shine no more at all in thee. And the voice of the bridegroom and of the bride shall be heard no more at all in thee. For thy merchants were the great men of the earth. For by thy sorceries were all the nations deceived, man. You know? And that goes into what I was saying earlier, man. The sorceries, you know, the TV, the media, the medicine, the doctrines, the philosophies. You know, all these things are part of, you know, Esau's tools that he uses, man, to deceive the masses, right? Now that technology that was used right there in that concert or wherever the hell that was, he's going to use that. That's that Project Bluebeam, right? But they've been had Project Bluebeam. That shit ain't nothing new. So you best believe that the mad scientist, the evil genius, has been in his lab and he's been perfecting that Project Blue Beam even more through the spirit and power of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh. Of course, I give this man no credit. No credit at all. But you know, through the spirit and power of the Heavenly Father on the left side, he's been perfecting that craft, man, to make it even more realistic, you know, more believable when people see it. So yeah, I believe, man, as we all do, man, something big is about to happen, man, because there's too many psyops out there for something not to happen. You know, he's building it up. He's building it up slowly but steadily, man. You know, that's that gradualism. That's what he's doing. He's building it up slowly but steadily. Something going to pop off, man. Something definitely is going to pop off. Let's get, I'm going to make this quick. Let's get Proverbs 21. And it says, wine is a mocker and strong drink is raging, and whosoever is deceived therefore or thereby is not wise. And a lot of these people out here are dead from the neck up. They're going to be deceived by whatever this man brings out. A lot of these people, for the most part, believe everything that's on the news. You know, if you go through the comments of some of these videos, you know, they'll say, well, if it's not on the news, then it's not true. People believe everything that this devil puts on the news is true. A lot of it is made up and put together and edited to make it believable, to deceive the people. And these people are easily deceived. So if this man wants to cook up some type of bullshit, you know, using his technology, man, you know, people, you know, to try and get people to fall in line, the people are going to believe it, man. The people are going to believe it, man. A lot of these people out here, they're just sheep. They're just sheep being led to the slaughter, man. You know, not looking left, not looking right, just moving straight forward. You know, in that go along to get along spirit, you know, not a backbone at all, man. Just do what they're told. Let's get 2 Corinthians 2:11. A classic. It says, lest Satan should get an advantage of us, but we are not ignorant of his devices, right? And we playing chess out here. We know what evil E gonna do before he do it. You know, we 10 steps ahead of him, man. We already know what the end game is going to be. We know what the end result is going to be for him, right? And he knows too. But he's so proud, he don't believe it, right? Even though he knows, he still doesn't believe it, right? But we 10 steps ahead of him. So we know that now we're in the time of him trying to deceive people, man. Trying to cook up some bullshit. Because this man is in dire straits right now. This man is on the ropes. This man is catching body blows, head shots, uppercuts, left hooks. He's catching them all, man. Elbows. This man is catching everything, man. He got broken teeth, right? He done spit his mouth guard out. This man is about to go down, and he know it, right? But he's going to use everything that he can before he go. He's going to go down kicking and punching and scratching. Before he go down. So he's going to unleash all of his shit that he's created, man. All them robots, all that shit, man, is coming out. This man's going to bring all of these things out, man. You know? But lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices. We're not. We're privy to it, man. We know what's going on, man. We know what this man is trying to do. We know what this man is trying to accomplish. We know who this man is trying to be. Right? Who he can never be. He can never be the Heavenly Father, the Most High. Let me get, let's get Matthew 24:24, right? And it says, for there shall arise false Hamashiachs and false prophets and shall show great signs and wonders, insomuch that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect, right? Now, elect ain't going to be fooled by, you know, Esau's, you know, his technology, man. And the bullshit that he's trying to do. You know, of course, all the other people are going to be deceived by it, ultimately leading them to do what? Take that MOTB, right? They're going to be cast in a lake of fire, which is America being destroyed, by the nuclear missiles. That's that fire that they're going to be burned by ultimately, you know, in the end, in the fullness of time, you know. But this man is not deceiving us with these works that he thinks are great, you know, great works. You know, these people out here are just, they're through, man. And I can't wait to see what the Heavenly Father has this man do, right? I would really want to see and waiting to see how the people react to it and how deep they're into it. You know, how easily they're deceived by it, man. That shit is coming. Something's coming, man, real soon, man. Something is coming real soon. Let's get, I'm about to end it. I got two more and I'm gonna end it. Let's get 2 Thessalonians, 2nd chapter. It says, let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called the Heavenly Father, all that is worship, so that he as God sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. Remember ye not that when I was yet with you, I told you these things. And now ye know what withholdeth, that he might be revealed in his time. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work, Salakia, only he who now letteth will let, talking about the Heavenly Father, until he be taken out of the way. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. You know, Revelation 1 and 7. And it says, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, right, with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this cause, the Heavenly Father shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie. You know, and a lot of people are going to believe a lie. Esau believes his own fucking lies, man. He's a pathological liar. So he believes his own lies. He lies so much. He believes that his lies are the truth, you know? So a lot of these people, man, they got something coming. They not even paying attention to it, man. They not even paying attention to people. You know, shit is so bad out here right now. People are still going on about their business like shit ain't going down, like things ain't happening, like things aren't shifting and changing, man. So whatever the Heavenly Father has Esau cook up is going to catch a lot of these people off guard, man. It's going to catch them off guard, right? Now, the same wisdom that the Heavenly Father gave Esau, you know, to pretty much, you know, create these things, these special effects, you know, and all that, you know, the Heavenly Father going to flip it and reverse it on all of y'all, man. You know, the Heavenly Father knows your fears, man. Wisdom of Solomon, the 17th chapter. The Heavenly Father knows all of your fears. You know, he's going to use people's fears against them. I believe that's Isaiah. Let's get Isaiah 66, and I'm going to end it here. Isaiah 66. I'm going to read 3 and 4. I don't went to 9. Let's get 3 and 4. It says, he that killeth an ox is as if he slew a man. He that sacrificeth a lamb as if he cut off a dog's neck. And he that offereth an oblation as if he offered swine's blood. He that burneth incense as if he blessed an idol. Yea, they have chosen their own ways, and their soul delighteth in their abominations. I will also choose their delusions, and I will bring their fears upon them. You see that? The Heavenly Father is going to bring people's fears upon them, man. The Heavenly Father knows the secret parts. The people know, I mean, he knows the fears of people, man. He knows everyone's fear. He know what to scare you to death. He know what to give you a straight up heart attack so that you sit there and you die, man, and give up the spirit. That's why they call the Heavenly Father the King of Terrors, man. I will also choose their delusions and will bring their fears upon them, because when I called, none did answer. When I spake, they did not hear, but they did evil before my eyes and chose that in which I delighted not. Okay, and that's the two-thirds, that's Esau, the other nations, right? But mainly I'm talking about the two-thirds, man, you know? And chose that in which I delighted not. And that's what they choose to do with what the Heavenly Father does not delight in, man. You know, so a lot of these two-thirds out here are going to be caught off guard, man. They too busy, you know, trying to have fun, trying to sleep with other men's wives, right? These women out here too busy trying to jump from man to man, right? Trying to do shit behind people's back, thinking they slick. You know, these men out here too preoccupied with selling drugs and getting high, you know, thinking about who they going to rob next, who they going to do dirty next. You know, the Heavenly Father does not delight in these things, man. And you best believe the Heavenly Father knows your fears as well, man. You know, as saith the Lord through his prophet Isaiah. You know, I will also choose their delusions, man, and will bring their fears upon them. That's some scary shit right there, man. You know, but these days is coming, man. It's going to get worse and worse out here, man, as we move along. It's going to get worse and worse. And every day we seeing things happening every day. And I say that in a lot of my lessons, man, because it's a beautiful thing to see these things unfolding right before our face, man. It's a beautiful thing to see, you know, but not so beautiful for those whose eyes are darkened, because they don't know what the hell is going on. Well, soon they're going to know that it's the Lord that did it to them. Shalom.